Uniting America with truth, justice, and independence. This is the Norman Goldman Show.
I heard a commercial, I don't know if it was just here in Chicago, but it was talking about the help for the people in Oklahoma.
Yes.
Which is great. I wish everyone would do what they can. But speaking of which, who does what they can, I was just curious, are you aware of who is the biggest contributor towards those types of causes and, you know, the needs of people here in the country and throughout the world?
I believe the answer is Republicans give most to private charity.
That is correct. It's the old white guys that you're always complaining about.
Well, but you know why that is, right?
Well, they got the money.
No. That's not true. Because you find that if you look at the stats, John, what you find is the poorest people actually give the most in terms of percentage of their income. It's because the Republicans, as a matter of ideology and philosophy, believe that charity is a personal, private thing, that giving must come from an individual out of the goodness of their heart, that government as an institution is illegitimate for taking care of people when they are in trouble, and that the role of government is not to take care of people by way of Medicare or Social Security or taking care of widows and orphans or giving out reconstruction loans, when a tornado hits Oklahoma. The role of the church and the individual, out of the goodness of their heart, is to take care of these folks. That's why the Republicans do it. And by the way, that was the way this nation did taking care of the unfortunates and those who fell on hard times prior to the Great Depression. That's just the way it was done.
Correct, until Roosevelt came along and kind of said, hey, wait a second, the government needs to help with this. It's not going that great.
But the reason for that, John, was because this nation had grown, by the time of the Great Depression, that this nation had grown so big that private charity couldn't handle the load. And so this is the problem. When America, the first census in the United States, first census, 1790, it's in the Constitution, 4 million people. 4 million, there was no internet, there were no cars, no phones, no airplanes, no helicopters. Everything was very decentralized. Everyone knew their neighbors. Everyone lived in little towns. I mean, even the cities. I mean, Boston in 1790 would be considered, a tiny suburb today. So everybody knew their neighbors, and there were these, charity hospitals. People did take care of their neighbors, and things were very localized, right? To just travel from Boston to Washington, D.C. was a multi-day journey on horseback. But, the nation grew. By the time Roosevelt became president, this nation had about 150 million people in it, or 130 million people in it. I mean, the nation had grown so big and so complex, when the economy collapsed, private charity couldn't take care of it all. The people who believe that it is ideologically and philosophically wrong for government to take care of people are living in a bygone era that is long gone, John.
Uniting America with truth, justice, and independence. This is the Norman Goldman Show.